Chris Borland with a stop.
That's the Chris Borland that most Badger fans remember, the All-American middle linebacker who went on to the NFL and quickly established himself as a rookie destined for stardom. But then suddenly, the rookie sensation stunned everyone by walking away, retiring over concerns about concussions.
How difficult was that for you, and why did you do that?
That was the most difficult thing that I've ever done. It was hard for me personally to justify continuing down that path as a middle linebacker. In terms of the game being made safe within the lines, I think we've reached an impasse. I don't think you can still have it be football and be entirely safe.
Given what you know now, though, would you do it differently?
If I could go back, there's a few instances where I played through concussions that I wouldn't do, knowing what I know today.
His decision to quit put a spotlight on the issue of brain injuries in football. ESPN labeled Borland the most dangerous man in football, and he became a key figure in that national debate.
But that was distressing over time, getting calls from, you know, wives who've become caregivers who are grieving, or from mothers of young kids who had injuries or even taken their lives, and wasn't prepared for that.
To anyone who saw Chris Borland play, his passion for the game was clear, but when he suddenly retired, he didn't just leave the playing field, he left everything about football behind.
Do you watch football now?
I don't watch football.
Instead, Borland has found a new path forward.
Meditation is something that actually helped me deal with that.
These days, Borland teaches meditation and mindfulness near his home in Los Angeles. And he's recently teamed with UW's Center for Healthy Minds, traveling the country to share his message.
We are constantly training our minds.
On Thursday night, the former Badger star returned to the UW campus, sharing his thoughts both about the risks of the game he once loved.
If you had a child, would you let your child play football?
I don't think so.
And about the new direction in his life.
Never thought I'd be here 5 years ago, but I'm really happy.
Kent, it was surprising to hear him say that he doesn't even watch football anymore. Did he say why?
Yeah, he said morally it's tough for him to support the NFL knowing that many players will suffer cognitive impairment later in life. But also he told me that football just doesn't hold his attention for 3.5 hours anymore.
Interesting. Right. And he's opened a new chapter in his life.
He has.
Kent, thank you.